Hi, welcome to today's topic. So you might have seen today, the law of sedition is unconstitutional. And also, there was a few days back, there was an article in the Hindu countering the political act that has a legal grab on June 23rd. So what is this sedition? See here, what is this sedition is all about? And why it is, they are saying it is an unconstitutional, why this sedition is called as unconstitutional. And why they are saying we have to review the Kedarnath judgment is necessary, which is violates the basic rights of speech and expression under Article 19.1. So from this perspective, in the last slide also here, there was a Asia Sultana, activist of filmmaker who made a controversial comment about the bioweapons are in the Lakshadweep has been put under the sedition. So, and you know that Lakshadweep people have had sedition slapped against them for putting placards or posters against the Prime Minister. So Mrs. Sultana case also reveals that it is a political strategy to threaten the dissents. So, about the bio remarks, she has been booked for sedition over the marks against the administrator Patel for using bioweapon as used for Ireland during the TV debate while talking about the change in the COVID standard operating protocols in the Ireland. Later, she clarified comparing it is not that bioweapon or the government or the country, but still the sedition charges has been slapped by the police against Asia Sultana. Like that, there are many who have been slapped the sedition charges. So there are many who has been slapped the sedition charges. So Asia Sultana is one, and also there was a cartoonist, Ashin Trivedi. He was a cartoonist. He was also slapped. Vinod Dubey, he was also slapped the sedition charges. So in this context, we are going to see what is the sedition, what is the relevance of the law, why it should be repealed, and what the Supreme Court judgment says about this sedition. So sedition is talking about these things. Okay, so here we'll see what is sedition first. Before going to the sedition, we have to know what are the historical backgrounds of sedition charges or sedition provisions. Now, sedition was enacted in the 17th century itself. But in the year 1870, it was added in your IPC. Now, why 1870? Question is, why 1870? It was inserted in 1870. Why? But why not in 1860? But why I'm talking 1860 here? 1860 is where your IPC, Indian Penal Code, was enacted. Why not in 1860? Why 1870 only? So there is a government in England government, and this England government, the basic idea of the England government was, to entertain only good opinions, good opinion will be entertained. Not the negative opinions will be entertained by the government, and negative opinions always leads to the instability. So this was, you know, the historical background. But as you see this, the famous sedition trials during the freedom. In the 19th and 20th century, the sedition law, if you see, the sedition law is generally from the colonial era. So it has been made from the colonial rule. Why it has been made? It has been enacted, sedition law has been enacted in India during the Indian independence movement, mainly to stifle the voice of the national leaders. Like that, in the 19th and 20th century, those who involved in the Indian national leaders, the initial cases that invoked the sedition includes numerous prosecutions against the editors of the national newspaper, like Joginder Chandra Bose. For the editor Bongo Basi, he wrote an article criticizing the Age of Content Bill for posing the threat to their religion and for its relationship with Indians. So Bongo Basi is a newspaper. Joginder Chandra Bose was arrested and sedition charges were slapped against him. Not only him, Bal Gangadhar Tilak was also there, and also the Mahatma Gandhi. Sedition charges were slapped. So this is about sedition. Now we have to know what is sedition, then only you can answer in your these things. What is this sedition? What is this sedition law tells me? See, sedition, it comes under section 124A of the Indian Penal Code. So sedition, meaning of this sedition is simply whatever you are telling anything, whatever you are telling anything in the form of writing, speaking, signs, cartoons that result into the disaffection against the government. If there is a disaffection against the government, then the sedition charges under section 124A of IPC will be imposed on the individual or slapped. So what are the punishments here? See, what are the punishment? Mainly, what are the punishments? So punishments are simply under this. First is 3 years jail or life imprisonment. Okay, second, passport of the government of India will not be provided to the individual on whom these sedition charges were slapped. And third is your visit a court. So court, whenever they ask you that to visit frequently, so you need to be present there. Okay, that is the case. And the fourth one, the government jobs, you are not eligible to write the government jobs if you are convicted under the section 124A of the Indian Penal Code. Then see, it is written also, whoever by the words either spoken or written or by the signs, visible representation or otherwise bring an attempt to hasten the crime or attempts to disaffection towards the government established by the law shall be punished imprisonment of life, to which fine may be added, with imprisonment which may extend to 3 years, which may fine be added or with fine. So this is about definition of this sedition. So, you see, why the sedition law should be scrapped? Sedition law should be scrapped. Jawaharlal Nehru in the parliament clarified that the related penal provisions of the section 124A, the penal provisions of the section 124A is highly, section 124A is highly objectionable and obnoxious. So the sooner we get rid of it, better. The sooner we'll get rid of it, better. This was a statement in the parliament which was given by the Jawaharlal Nehru at that time. But why this law should be repealed? That is the question. The law should be repealed mainly because of its vague definitions which we have. What are the vague definitions? You see, vague definition. That means here the most important is vague definition. What is this vague definition tells? See, anything which create disaffection against the government, anything which creates disaffection against government. So if anything which is creating disaffection against the government is a matter of subjective term, it is a matter of subjective term. So it can be interpreted differently. It can be interpreted so differently. So when this interpreting so differently, then it is a vague definition. That is one thing. Now, second is Krapp-Hoover introduced it. Who introduced it? England introduced it. And England has already scrapped in the year 2009 this sedition charges of slapping sedition charges by the police or enforcement agencies on the individuals. So this is one. Then right to dissent. So what is this right to dissent is? See, in our constitution, the government, the fundamental rights have provided us right to criticize the government, right to question the government, and the right to change the government after 5 years of rule. And these all rights is a part of your right to dissent. And all these rights, right to criticize, question the government, change the government. So all these are rights, or these are fundamental or foundations for any good democracy. And all these are a part of your civil rights, which are there. But, you know, they are part of the civil rights, but the government is denying it. Okay, so disutility of the law. So what is this disutility of the law means? Disutility means that according to National Crime Record Bureau, only 3% of conviction in case of sedition. So Supreme Court already said, like, for example, you see, recently, 2 months back, there was a sedition charges imposed on the MP, member of parliament in Andhra Pradesh, because he has, and also on the Telugu news channel also, there was a sedition charges imposed because the MP has spoken against the chief minister or the government of Andhra Pradesh. So Supreme Court said that at that time, there was a 3-judge bench, Justice Chandrachur. Now, Justice Chandrachur said that we are going to examine and validate the section 124A of the sedition. And also Supreme Court judges said that we are going to fix area, incidents, and the limits on basis of which the sedition charges or law can be slapped on individuals by the police. So these are what happened in this case. Only 3% are convicted, and alternative laws, already there are alternative laws we have in our constitution, UPA and IPC. See, slapping charges against individual, see, under this UPA and IPC, we can slap a charges against individual if he is creating any public nuisance or he is disobeying the public policy or order by the government. So already we have alternative. Why we need an alternative law? Now, what is the relevance of the law then? Why we say we have to, see, as a UPSC, we have to know both pros and cons also. So what is the relevance of the law? Relevance of the law, first is reasonable restrictions. See, under Article 19.1, what is 19.1 talks about? It is the right to freedom of speech and expression. So already we have a right to freedom of speech and expression. Now, the same under this, below this, the article provides that there is another article which talks about 19.2, that reasonable restrictions. Reasonable restrictions are provided under this. So what is this reasonable restrictions is? If your speech or expression is against the sovereignty, security, or integrity of the country, then there will be a reasonable restrictions imposed on them. So that is called reasonable restriction. Then secessionist tendency. Secessionist tendency is, see, everywhere we have some problems in our country. Everywhere. Even if you take Northeast, we have problem of insurgency. Okay, Northeast, we have problem of insurgency groups. In the middle part of the country, that is central part of the country, we have problem of Naxalism. And we have problem of insurgency, Naxalism, and Jammu and Kashmir militancy. And, you know, sometimes some groups, they also take the movement. There is a movement, Khalistan movement. They also take some route whenever they want it. So to curb, see, secessionist tendency means like Khalistan movement. If some groups or organization or some kind of people wanted to make India or part of India separately from India, then we need such laws to be imposed. That is called secessionist tendency. They are called secessionist tendencies. Then we have the stability of the government. See, we are electing the government, and the government we for every 5 years, and that government should be a major government. And also the every year we cannot conduct an election. So for stable government, we need a stable policy. Only the stable government can make this stable policy. And for that, the stable policy is one of the fundamental component of your good governance. And the last is contempt of court, of government. See, like contempt of court, you have, why not? A contempt should be there for the government also. So that is an argument put for the government. So the Law Commission, you know, we will see from the view of Law Commission and Supreme Court, what are the views of this? Now, in this view, in the year 1968 and 69 or 78 and 78, there was a report of 38 and 42 Law Commission report. Law Commission, and they said that to scrap the sedition charges, sedition should not be scrapped at all. But in the year 2018, August, the Law Commission said that the Law Commission published a consultation paper recommending that to rethink or repeal the Section 124. Okay, the Section 124A of the IPC. This was a Law Commission. Then Supreme Court also said that there are two important cases of the Supreme Court, Kedarnath Singh versus State of Bihar. See, in the Kedarnath Singh of the state versus State of Bihar, the court said that there should be some provision on slapping the sedition charges against the individual. That means if he is writing or telling something or signs which is visible, which is creating or have a potential to create violence or incitement violence. So this was a Kedarnath Singh said.
in Balwant Singh versus state of Punjab, you know, there was a slogans in the court itself, Jai Khalistan. So we want Khalistan. The slogans were raised in favor of Khalistan movement. In the court itself, there was a sloganery. So Supreme Court said that in this Balwant Singh versus state of Punjab, court verdicted that mere sloganery does not amount to incitement of violence. Mere sloganery does not amount to the incitement of violence. Then Shankar Marathe versus state of Maharashtra and others. They said that in this case, you know, who was arrested? Political cartoonist Ashin Trivedi. And in that, state government itself admitted and said that we will issue a circular or guidelines to the police on what parameters the sedition charges has to be imposed on the individuals. Then also in Pankaj Bhutalia versus CBFC, Central Board of Film Certificate, Delhi High Court said that the spoken or written should be seen in the comprehensive manner, not an in the individual manner. So police should look into it comprehensively and holistically rather than isolated passage or speech. Then sedition charges can be slapped against the person. Now the conclusion is the Law Commission has rightly said an expression of frustration over the state of affairs cannot be treated as sedition. If the country is not open to the positive criticism, there will be no difference between the pre and post independence eras. Of course, it is essential to protect the national integrity, given that legal opinion and the views of government in favor of law. It is unlikely that section 124A will be scrapped soon. However, the section should not be misused as a tool to curb the free speech and expression. Thank you.